Welcome back to the channel. Today's video, I'll be covering the new integration of Python and Excel. This officially rolled out last month and is now available over every version of Excel. And this will be an introduction. So if you're not familiar with Python, I'll try to give you the basics on what it is and how it can be used in Excel, as well as going over a few of the samples and some use cases. So Python is a general purpose programming language that was initially made to be a bit more readable and use natural language, and is very commonly used in machine learning and data science. And as you'll see as we progress through some of the different functionalities, it will most commonly be used for some sort of data science and analysis in Excel, but we'll have many other specific cases where it can be useful as well. So to get into how we want to get Python and use the integration, we'll just navigate to the Formulas tab, and there will be a Python section here. So a few quick things. If we click Insert Python, this will launch the Python editor. So much like we type in a cell, we are typing in a cell that is now changed to Python functions. So we can now type our code in here, and then we'll hit Control Enter. And over on the right, they do have a quick tour of Python in Excel. And I do think that these are good examples to get familiar, and they do a good job at showing a couple of the different use cases and the different libraries that are shown. And why Python is so powerful is because of the different libraries. So before we get into actually writing any Python in Excel, if we go back to the Formulas tab, we can hit Initialization, which will show the different libraries and how they are imported. And these are some very common libraries used when writing Python, as they are very functional and provide a bunch of different uses. And so I do have a table that is different beverage data from products, categories, unit prices, and quantity. And just to show you some of the different basic things, we can also type equals pi, which will create Python formulas. So if we double click that, we will now be able to write Python. So Python's very good at working with arrays and storing data, which is a lot of the cases of how we'd use it in Excel. And so if we just type any formula name, so for this case, we'll just put bev, since this is a beverage table, equals, and then we can grab a range. So if we just grab this whole table, we can hit Control and Enter to submit the Python, and then this will just load and store the data. So this will create a Python data frame, which will be a way to store the data as an array, and this is how we'll work with different libraries in different functions within this Python data frame. So if we click Array Preview, this gives you a preview of the first rows of the table and the last rows. And you can also see the type, which this will be a pandas chord frame or data frame, which will be useful once you know some of the other functionalities and how to use them within Python. But with this being an introduction, we'll try to keep it simple and give you some different tools for the more research you want to do and how to learn. So if we just go back into this Python code, we can create a chart and do some visualization with some of the different libraries. So Seaborn, which is one of the libraries in SNS, since that's how it was initialized. If we bring that back up, the different libraries are imported as a different name. So Seaborn is SNS. So SNS.scatterplot. And for this, we'll want to add in the data, and the data will be the variable bev, which is the data frame of that table. Then comma, then we'll want to do x equals, and for this, we can type in the column name. So we could do unit price as the x axis, and then y equals, and we can do total price. So this will be making a scatter plot based on the unit price to the total price to see the correlation, and if there's any relationship between them. And so this will generate an image. So if we open the editor with this selected, we can see that this is the image that was presented, and we can also click on this to create an image in this cell. We do need to make this cell a good bit bigger to actually see it, but we can see that the relationship appears to be that the higher the unit price, the larger the order will be, at least in the cases of these outliers on this side. Although this isn't a statistically sound example, this will be one of the use cases where you can use Seaborn to create scatter plots and test regressions and relationships and a lot of the statistical analysis that could be involved with a data set. And so one quick thing I did want to mention is that if you're interested in learning about how to use these different libraries in Python and Excel, if we head over to their websites, so in this case, this is Seaborn's website, you can look at tutorials, you can go over different features and visualizing statistical relationships, distributions of data, and this will go over the different syntax along with, you know, the common approach of different distributions and some of the statistical analysis, which is very important if you're trying to learn, whether for work or for personal reasons, a lot of what the use cases of these different libraries are. So this is just Seaborn, and this will be NumPy, which is also imported into Excel and is very commonly used. There's documentation. There's also some different learning options that are available, and this will be another good way to get started with your journey to learn Python and a couple of different use cases that you can then bring into Excel, as Excel is kind of a great way to simplify a lot of the different interfaces that you can go with and is a pretty simple tool to share reports and show data to people that maybe are not as into the technical part of the different coding languages. And the last library I'll quickly cover will be Pandas, which will have a lot of different options on what to look at, the different documentation, and how it can be used, as well as you'll be able to find tons of videos on YouTube and other resources that will do deep dives into these different libraries. And so another quick useful tool will be the describe function, which is used from Pandas data frame, which this is already how the data is formatted in this variable, which is bev, is this data frame. So if we do this variable dot describe, which is a Pandas function, we can delete this since that was the image, and we can do array preview, which will then describe. So we'll include the count, the mean, standard deviation, and the percentages within these columns, and the unit price, quantity, total price. So this will be a useful tool to quickly describe a data set. And this is something you could immediately implement in Excel if there's different statistical aspects you're looking at. I did want to keep this video short and really just an introduction. Comment below if you're interested in seeing more in-depth concepts with Python and Excel. But that's all I have for you in this video. If you enjoyed it, please like and subscribe. And thanks for watching.